On today's What I Do.
This is the best seat in the house.
Sitting pretty today, thanks to God. 8 years ago, Walter De La Riva had money problems and no job.
You look back on it and you can see the exact, every step he had planned for us.
Welcome to What I Do. I'm Rob Melnichuk. This is a show that celebrates your workplace calling. In debt and out of a job twice, today, Walter De La Riva is a successful businessman whose comeback is connected to Christ.
I'm Walter De La Riva, and this is What I Do. This is the best seat in the house.
What we do is we bring in chairs and seats, and we do different installations in stadiums, arenas. We also have bleachers that we install in universities, colleges, and high schools. There's approximately 2,500 to 3,000 seats in here.
Proud owner of SDR Seating today. Rewind a few years back, and Walter's finances and future didn't look good until God literally jumped into the passenger seat with a game plan.
I was driving to work one day, and God told me to get out of debt. And I sort of, you know, Lord, is that you talking to me, or is it my conscience? What exactly is it? And it just kept coming back. I want you to get out of debt.
With his wife and faith on his side, he put God's words into action.
We were out of debt within a very short period of time, about 6 to 8 months.
Giving God the green light to go ahead with phase two of his plan.
We were away in Ottawa at the time, and I get a phone call from my boss.
And I remember coming into the room, Walter was on the phone, his face just looked, I could tell something was up.
So I get off the phone with my boss, and I tell her that they're closing down the office. But he mentioned that maybe we can open a business and be the distributor dealer for the seating company. And the first thing she said to me, she said,
this was exactly what we were waiting for. This was it. God was giving us, and we had the capital because we were out of debt.
You look back on it, and you can see the exact, every step he had planned for us.
Back on track and a believer. Still, a few years later, Walter got a good reminder and more reason to never question.
It was quite busy, so we decided to hire. And with prayer, the Lord said that to hire two people. Well, I guess I got a little gun shy and I hired one. And during that period, we didn't seem to expand. Well, after I hired the second person, we absolutely exploded. It was just incredible. We doubled our revenue.
And now with 15 people on the payroll, Walter's booming business is the perfect example of God at work.
You know, it's funny that God uses increments when he's leading you. God really showed us that there really is something he's doing here with Christian businesses. He's raising them up.
So then I really felt that this company was here to help, whether it was different ministries, whether it was for kids, women's shelters, teenage shelters, and other ministries. We were taught at the time that God was bringing up different companies for his work. So Suzanne and I again we're praying, and we noticed that God was really blessing us, and that's where we really, really started to see the importance of tithing for our company, not only personally, but the company had to tithe and give money to these different ministries.
We knew that God gave us this business. It's his business, and this is why I do what I do.
Bad seats are bad for the body and bad for business. Not an issue for Walter, who's, quote, busting out of his office and needs three times more space. Thankful for the success, Walter and his wife Suzanne practice the biblical principle of tithing, meaning 10% of their company profits go to various charities. On today's listener poll, we want to know, do you think more companies should do the same? Email us at whatido@crossroads.ca and then go to crossroads.ca/whatido for the results. That's all for What I Do this time. But before we go, Here's author and leadership expert John Maxwell with advice on how to inspire the people who work for you.
One of the most important leadership lessons I've ever learned is that if you're lonely at the top, you're not doing something right. Now, I know that when we hear the leadership expression, it's lonely at the top, we think of some leader who's all alone at the top, looking down at all of his or her followers saying, oh, it's lonely at the top. But really, a leader never said that. Think about it for a moment, would you please? If you're at the top all alone, nobody's following you. In fact, if you're kind of a lonely leader, I would suggest you get off the top, go down to the bottom, find the people, walk slowly through the crowd, bring them with you to the top. You see, leaders are known by the fact that not that they're on the top and everybody is down beneath them. Leaders are known by the fact that they take people to the top with them. And that's been a very important lesson I've learned, and I hope it'll help you in your walk too.